Assalamu alaikum students, hope you all are good at home, enjoying your vacations. Welcome all, welcome to the Zoom class, Zoom online class. This is your English teacher and today we are going to continue our unit number one. We are going to do exercises in this unit as we have read the unit in the previous lecture. So we are going to do the exercises. For this, you have to take a pencil in your hand. If you want to write it on the book, you have to use pencil for it, okay? Open your book, page number 5. The first exercise is exercise A. Question, answers. Answer the following questions. Answer the following questions. Here I have ready it for you people. I have prepared it for you. Okay, who first spotted Fungi the dolphin? Who was the man? What was the name of the man? Yes, Paddy Ferretter. Paddy Ferretter spotted Fungi the dolphin. Question number 2 is, do you think fishermen like fungi? Yes, of course. Fishermen like fungi. Yes, the fishermen like fungi. Question number 3 is, what kind of tricks did fungi do? Tricks. What kind of tricks a dolphin do? Fungi would tease the fishermen by swimming under and jumping over their boats. Okay, boys, there are 2 words for you. That is under and over. Under and over. Both are prepositions. What are these words? These words are preposition. In grammar, we say these words are preposition. What is a preposition? A preposition is a word which shows positions of a noun. Okay? Which shows position of a noun. Now here, they are saying that the fungi, the dolphin, swim under. Under means niche. Under the boat. And jump over means upper, over the boat. Okay, these were 2 tricks that fungi usually do. Now coming to the next question, that is, what kind of dolphin is fungi? Fungi was what kind of dolphin? We have discussed the kinds of the dolphins. No, so fungi was a bottlenose and friendly dolphin. Fungi was a bottlenose and friendly dolphin. Question number 5 is, write 3 words that describes fungi. Okay, for description, it could be her qualities or it could be her physique. So we are going to mention here her qualities. Okay, number 1, you can write in the block. You can write it in these blocks. Okay, in these blocks. You are going to write in these blocks, friend, playful, mischievous. Friend, playful, and mischievous. Is it clear to you, boys? Now, question number 6. Why do you think fungi stayed in the dingle? Why do you think? Why she stayed in the dingle? Because people loved her. People loved her. Why she stayed? Because people loved her. Okay, the fishermen and the people of the dingle loved her so very much. So, we are done with our exercise A. Those were the question answers. Okay, now we are go up to exercise B. Exercise B is the true and false. Okay, for true and false, what are you going to do is, I have used a color pencil for it, but you can simply write a tick or for a cross for false if you want to. Okay, the first one is, fungi was spotted by Paddy Ferretter. Is it true? Yes, of course, it's true. It was spotted by the Paddy Ferretter. Question sentence number 2 is, fungi came to Dingle 20 years ago. There is not specific time mentioned. There is no specific time of period mentioned in the unit. So we are going to say this one is false. This one is false. Then, fungi had no interest in the fisherman. Did she take no interest in the fisherman? No, because she takes interest. Even she wants to be friends with the fisherman. Okay, so this is false. The next is, the fisherman tried to kill fungi. No, it's false. Next, the fisherman told nobody about the fungi. No, they told everybody. So this is going to be false. The fisherman felt safe with fungi. Of course, yes, they feel safe with fungi. Okay, next is, dolphins are not fish. No, it's false. They are fish. They are fish. Okay, they are fish. Next is, dolphins are not very clever. It's a kind of true because they're saying not very clever. They are so sweet, so innocent. Okay, okay. Dolphins are super swimmers. Yes, of course, this is true. Dolphins are super swimmers. Now coming on page number 6, this is the grammar exercise, okay, related to grammar. In today's lecture, we are going to learn capital letters and full stops. So what is a capital letter? What are the uses of this capital letter? We are going to read this, okay? Capital letters, there are some specific rules. There are some specific rules through which we are going to learn that where we have to use the capital letters. Number one is, a capital letter is always used at the start of the sentence. Always remember this. Next, it is also used for names and surnames. For example, this is a name, Michal, and this is the surname, Suhail. So the M of the Michal and S of the Suhail will be capital. Also used for place names, for example, K of Karachi and L of London, both will be capital. Next, also used for days of the week, for example, M of Monday, S of Saturday, it could be F of Friday, T of Tuesday, it would be capital. Also used for months of the years, okay? J for July, N of November and S of September would be capital. So these were the rules for the capitalization of the letters. And now a full stop. Full stop. Where we use full stop? We use full stop to end a sentence. See, I have put in it here. I have marked a full stop here. So this is showing me that this sentence is over now. It's finished now. Okay, you have these exercises related capital letters and full stop. So we are going to do this. Rewrite these sentences using capital letters and full stops. What you have to do is, you have to rewrite means dubara likhenge, theek hai, usi ke niche. Okay, I have written it for you. You can see this. Number one is, we have no homework on a Friday. No. So, the W of the week would be capital and F of the Friday would be capital because it's the start of the sentence and it's a day of the week. That's why both would be capital. Yes. Second is, I love going to France on holiday. Boys, remember one thing. I is the king of the alphabets. Okay? It's the king of the alphabets. That's why whenever you write I single, agar aap jab bhi single I likhte hain, it is always capital. Doesn't matter, it comes in the sentence or at the start of the sentence, you have to write it capital. But single I, not with N, not for with S, theek hai? Okay, I love going to France on holiday. I at the start of the sentence, France, F of the France, and at the last, you have to put a full stop here. Okay, number 3 is, Tom and Adam really like it here in Dubai. So, Tom and Adam are both the names. So, T of the Tom and A of the Adam will be capital. And Dubai is a place, so we are going to capital the D of Dubai. And at the end, there would be a full stop. Okay, next is, Sam's birthday is in August. Okay, S of the Sam, NA of the August, and it would be capital. Number 5 is, we are going to visit a wildlife park in a Cork. Okay, W of wild and L of life will also be capital because it's a name of a park and it's also a proper noun. Then S of the Sonia, S of the Spain, and J of the January will also be capital. Again, same, M of the Mr. and M of the Murphy would be capital as its name. And W of the Wednesday will also be capital. And the last one, T of the T of there and P of Paris would be capital. as same as S of Sunday. So I hope this exercise is clear to you. Now boys, exercise A is done. Now we are going to do exercise B. It's very, very simple. We just have to underline the words that are missing a capital letter. Okay? Jis word ko capital hona chahiye tha, jis letter ko capital hona chahiye tha, but wo capital nahi hai. We just have to underline this. Okay. Number one is, my mother's favorite cartoon is Tom and Jerry. Amazing. So M of the my is not capital, so we are going to underline this. This is also not capital, we are going to underline this. And G of the Jerry is not capital, we are going to underline this. Next is, we read a book about Michael Jackson last June. All the words are not capital, all the letters are not capital here, so we are going to underline these words also. Same in the third sentence. Three is, there and Monday would be underlined. Number four, on Saturday in Dubai, they would be capital. In number five, Allama Iqbal, both will be underlined as same as Pakistani. It's a nationality. We are going to underline this also. Okay, next is, don't. We are going to underline don't because it's at the start of the sentence, same as the Saturday, because it's the day of the week and it's not underlined, so we are going to underline this. Then again, I, same case would be here also, I and Tuesday, we are going to underline these, as in same as in the eighth sentence, I and Friday would be underlined. So in this class, we have done these two exercises. Inshallah, we will continue it in the next class. Till then, stay tuned, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.